leaders of political parties, religious and traditional leaders present, honored guests, ladies and gentlemen, all protocol observed, allow me on behalf of the President of the African Christian Democratic Party, Reverend Dr. Kenneth Meshwe, and our leadership to thank the President of South Africa for the invitation to the celebration of this important day in the history of South Africa. It would indeed be an injustice not to mention the role played by our former president, the late Mr. Nelson Mandela, in reconciling what was an extremely polarized nation prior to 1994. The African Christian Democratic Party gives that it is fitting that on this most significant day of our national calendar, we pay tribute to the late Tata Madiba by unveiling his statue in the manner which we have done today. He was indeed a man who turned his prison into a podium from which he pronounced freedom and liberty for the oppressed masses of our country. He preached the message of peace rather than plunder, racial harmony rather than hegemony, reconciliation rather than revenge. And for this, the ACDP says, we as a nation are eternally grateful. However, Program Director, it would be an even greater injustice if we fail to mention at this time the leader of some 2 billion people around the world, one who has given unto us the ministry of reconciliation, one who has told us to love our enemies, to turn the other cheek, to go the extra mile, to take care of the widow, to take care of the orphan. And it is this man who, when his followers chased little children away from him, he said to the little ones, suffer little children to come unto me and forbid them not, for of such is the kingdom of heaven. And this man is none other than the Messiah, Christ Jesus. It is the belief of the ACDP that as a young democracy, South Africa has shown remarkable maturity in taking the day celebrated prior to 1994 by the Afrikaner as a day of the Vaal and by the Zulu, as the day of Dingaan and by the ANC, as a day to commemorate the establishment of MK, and in turning this into a unifying day, now known as the Day of Reconciliation. It is no secret that one of the tasks of South Africa's first non-racial government was the promotion of reconciliation and national unity. In this vein, taking the 16th of December, which is celebrated differently by at least 3 different groups of people, and calling it the Day of Reconciliation for the first time in 1995, was a stroke of genius as a symbolic gesture of uniting our nation. As we celebrate the centenary of the Union Buildings as the seat of government in South Africa, let us be reminded that our work as political parties and as a nation is incomplete. We cannot rest on our laurels, for as long as we have inequality reflected by our Gini coefficient of some 0.2, we cannot rest for as long as we have high levels of poverty. We cannot rest as long as we have a high current account deficit of some 6.8 of our GDP, or a budget deficit of 4.6% of our GDP, and our children continue to struggle in the area of literacy and numeracy in our schools, and for as long as crime and corruption is not brought under control, we as a nation, we as political leaders, cannot rest. In conclusion, the ACDP is optimistic, and we can indeed all have a shared future in South Africa if we remain united as on this day of reconciliation and beyond in fighting the challenges of our country. And to this cause, Program Director and Mr. President, the ACDP commits itself. We wish all South Africans a peaceful day of reconciliation, a blessed and a merry Christmas, and a prosperous and abundantly blessed New Year. I thank you.